गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ मैथ्स ऑफ क्लास 9th. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्सियम्स एंड थियरम्स ऑफ द चैप्टर दैट इज द लाइंस एंड एंगल्स ऑफ क्लास 9th. सो आई हैड सम ऑफ ऑल द theorems and axioms of this chapter, the particular place in this particular sheet, and one by one I'll try to explain all the things, all the axioms and all the theorems, and simultaneously try to give the good explanation about that so that all of you can easily understand it and you can remember it. So let us begin it. Okay, so let us start with the first one. So here it is, axioms first. So if a ray stands on a line, then the sum of the two adjacent angles formed is 180 degree. So as the statement suggests, and since we know that axioms does not need any proof, so we are not going to prove the axioms, okay, but with the help of axioms only we are going to prove the theorems. Okay, so we have to keep this thing in our mind, and with the help of the sum of the theorems which is proved already, so we need we use the truthness of that particular theorem to prove the other theorems also. So we'll take care of these things. Well, okay, let's move on fastly now. So according to our statement, if a ray stands on a line, so let us suppose that we are having a line AB and a ray OC is standing on it. So obviously we are going to get two angles, different angles, X and Y. So these are the adjacent angles because it will satisfy all the three conditions of the adjacent angle. Now I'm not going to discuss over here right now what is adjacent angles. Okay, let us move on fastly now. So we can see that if a ray stands on a line, according to axioms, one, the x plus y is equals to 180 degrees. So this we also called as the another name of this is also as linear pair. Okay, now let's move on. So the another axiom: if the sum of the two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then the non-common arms of the angles form a line. So the converse we are going to see now. So if the sum of the angles are going to be 180 degree, so it means earlier if it is given that the sum of the two angles x plus y is equal to 180 degree, and so x plus y is equals to 180 degree, it is given already to you, so you can conclude that AB will be forming a straight line. So AB will be a straight line. You have to conclude that. Okay, if the sum of the two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then the non-common arm of the angles form a line. The non-common arms are going to form a line. Okay, now let's move on to the. Okay, now the theorem is going to be started. So based on these two axioms only, that this theorem is going to be proved. So that's why after these two axioms only, the theorem is coming. So let us see what it is. So it is saying that if two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are equal. This is also very easy to understand. I show you the figures. Okay, so we are taking two lines L and M, and you can easily see that the angles forming over here are angle 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so angle 1 is opposite to angle 3, so this is vertically opposite angle, and angle 2 is opposite to angle 4. So 4 is equal to 2. So I had written to prove angle 1 equals to angle 3 and 4 equals to angle 2. So you can see the proof. It is very easy to prove angle 1 plus angle 2 is equals to 180 degree, as we had seen here only right now. So let us use it now. Angle 1 plus 2 180 degree, and angle 2 plus 3 is equals to 180 degree. So if the RHS of both the equations are equal, so LHS will also be equal. We can state it like this also, with the help of the Euclid's axiom, that the things which are equal to the same thing are equal to each other. So these two are equal to each other, so angle 2 angle 2 cancel out, and directly we are going to get the result as angle 1 is equal to angle. So similarly we can write angle 4 is equal to angle 2. Let us move on for the another theorem. What is this? Okay, now axiom 3 we are having, axiom 3 and axiom 4, and after that we are going to see the theorems based on this. So if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of corresponding angles is equal. Okay, so if the transversal, let us suppose that the transversal we are taking over here is N, it is going to cut the parallel lines at the particular point, different distinct points L and M, the other parallel lines. Okay, so this is being cut by these two lines. Now The angles formed will be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. You can see the angles easily. So these things you people must have studied in class 7th also. But here we are going to see the proofs of these things. Okay, so angle 1 and angle 5 are going to form a corresponding angle pair, angle 2, angle 6, angle 3, angle 7, angle 4, angle 8. So these corresponding angles are going to be equal to each other. So you have to just keep it in your mind. You don't have to prove it. Okay. So this is the corresponding angle axioms. When our two parallel lines are intersected by the transversal. Okay. Now let us see the converse of it. So axiom 4 is here. Now it is saying that if a transversal intersects the two lines such that a pair of corresponding angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel to each other. Now the reverse of this, again we have to see that these two lines are given. We don't know initially that these two lines are parallel or not, but we are seeing that a transversal is there cutting it and the corresponding angles are becoming equal. So it is given that when a transversal cuts these two lines, angle 1 is equal to angle 5. So if angle 1 is equal to angle 5, it means it is showing that the corresponding angles are equal, and the corresponding angles are equal when the lines will be parallel. So the opposite is that. That angle 1 is equal to angle 5, so it means the line L is parallel to line M. So L is parallel to M, so this is proved, okay. This is one of the axiom, you know, so we don't need to prove it. So this will help us to prove the quotients or theorems if we want to prove that the two lines are parallel to each other, okay. So we'll have to keep this thing in our mind. Okay, now moving on to another one. So now the theorem 2, now the sequence of theorem is there. So just move on fastly. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of alternating triangles are equal. Each pair of alternating angles, interior angles is equal, okay. Now see each pair of alternating triangles. So first of all, try to understand. Okay, let us before moving through this theorem, let us try to understand first of all that exterior and interior angles, angle 1, 4, 6, 7, these are the exterior angles, 2, 3 and 5, 8 are the interior angles. Okay, now we have to see for the alternate interior angle pair. So I have written all the pairs over here. So you can see here alternate interior angles 2 and 8, 2 and 8, 3 and 5, 3 and 5. Alternate exterior angle 4 and 6, 1 and 7, 4 and 6, 1 and 7. Consecutive interior angles 3, 8, 2, 5. Now the properties. So these alternate interior angles are going to be equal to each other. Okay. Now height is going to be equal to each other. So this is the theorem, we have to prove it. Now verbally I'm just proving it. Okay, no need to prove it. So because this is very easy thing. So we want to show that 2 is equal to 8. Okay. So we know that 2 is equal to 4. Yes. Angle 2 is equal to angle 4, vertically opposite angle, and we can say that if these two lines are parallel, then angle 8 is equal to angle 4. So these two both angles are equal to the same angle, that is angle 2 is equal to angle 4 and angle 8 is equal to angle 4 by the corresponding angle property. So 2 is equal to 4, 8 is equal to 4, it means both are equal to the same thing. So it means these two angles are also equal. Similarly, angle 3 is equal to angle 5. Okay, now move on. So theorem 2 will stand. If a transversal intersects the two lines such that a pair of alternate interior angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel. So now we have to show the converse. Like if it is given already that angle 2 is equal to 8 and angle 3 is equal to angle 5, then now you have to prove that the lines are parallel. L is parallel to M. The opposite you have to prove. So here we are going to use the corresponding angle axioms and we can easily prove it. Okay. Now see this. So it is given that angle 2 is equal to angle 8. Very good. Now we'll again use the same thing. Now if we'll show that angle 4 is equal to angle 8, then we can get the corresponding angle axiom property and we can easily show that L is parallel to M. So okay, now let us see that. See this. So we can write that angle 4 is equal to angle 2 and angle 4 is equal to angle, sorry, and angle 2 is equal to angle 8. It is given. So angle 4 is equal to angle 2 and angle 8 is equal to angle 2. So here 2 is the common with which angle 4 is also equal and angle 8 is also equal. It is given. So if this is common, so obviously angle 4 is equal to angle 2 also. So we had shown that angle 4 is equal to angle 8. Angle 4 is equal to angle 8. So if angle 4 is equal to angle 8, it means that, what does it mean? It means that these are forming a corresponding angle pair. So L is parallel to M. Okay, now on. So theorem 4, now see if a transversal intersects the two parallel lines, then each pair of interior on the same side of the triangle. Okay, now here also we are going to see the theorem 4 and theorem 5, the corresponding angle, the consecutive angles we are going to see. So we have to prove now angle 3 plus angle 8 is equal to 180 degree and angle 2 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. This is the corresponding angle, consecutive interangle property, or we can call it also the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Okay, you can see that this is the transversal, so it is having two sides. First is this and the another is this. So two sides, so the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So you can see that this side 3 and 8 are there and these two are interior angles, so the same side of the transversal. So 3 and 8, similarly 2 and 5, okay, are the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So we can call it like this also, and we can call it like consecutive interior angles also. We can call it as co-interior angles also. So different names are there for this. Okay, now see, so angle 2 plus 5 is equals to 180 degree. We have to show that. So similarly, angle 3 plus 8 is equal to 180 degree. We'll show that. So we can easily write, it's very easy thing, 2 plus 1, angle 1 plus 2 is equals to 180 degree, and we know that angle 1 is equal to angle 5. So we can easily replace angle 1 with angle 5, and we can get angle 2 plus angle 5 is equals to 180 degree. So it's not a very big deal to do it. So similarly, you can show that angle 3 plus angle 8 is equal to 180 degree. Now I have solved this, it must be clear. Now the another thing it is showing that if angle 2 plus angle 5, the theorem 5, it is this, angle 2 plus angle 5 is given equals to 180 degree, it means co-interior angles are 180 degree, then you have to show that L is parallel to M. How you'll show that? Okay, now again we'll go for the corresponding angle axiom. So we know that 2 plus 5 is equals to 180 degree, we'll write that. Okay, 2 plus 5 is equals to 180 degree, it is given written one statement. Now angle 1 plus angle 2 is equals to 180 degree, linear pair again. So 180 180, well, RHS equals to RHS, so LHS will also equals to LHS. So now we can write that angle 1 plus angle 2 is equals to angle 2 plus angle 5. 2 will get cancelled, angle 1 is equals to angle 5. Again we had got it. So once we had again got it, angle 1 is equal to angle 5, so this is forming a corresponding angle pair again, and we can use the converse of the corresponding angle axiom, that is, if the corresponding angles are equal, so then the lines are parallel to each other. I hope so that the things being clear to you all. Okay, very less things are left now. Let us try to do it fastly. Lines which are the theorem 6 is lines which are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. Okay, now we have to show that the lines which are parallel to each means the same line are parallel to each other. Let us take the now it is visible to you people. So let us take the lines L, M and N. So we are taking initially that L is parallel to M and N is parallel to M. Okay, but we are not taking that L is parallel to N. We have to show that L is parallel to N. Okay, we have to show this, that at last we are going to get L is parallel to N. Okay, so I'm trying to prove that with you people. Come on, let us see it fastly. Just a second. Yeah. Okay. Now see this. So we have to show that since L is parallel to M, so we know that angle 1 is equals to angle 2. These two lines are parallel, so corresponding angles must be equal. And now I'm showing that we are taking that M is parallel to N, so angle 2 is equals to angle 3 also. So we know that angle 1 is equal to angle 2 and angle 3 is equal to angle 2. Again, this is becoming common. So the things which are being equal to the same thing are equal to each other. So we can show that easily that angle 1 is also equals to angle 3. So as we had shown angle 1 is equals to angle 3, it means that angle 1 is equals to angle 3, it means that L is parallel to N. Okay, L is parallel to N. Okay, by mistake I written M. So now it is clear L is parallel to N. So it is proved that with this theorem also. Now let us move on fastly. The two things more is left. Theorem 7 and theorem 8. So this is the sum of the angles of the interior angles of the triangle is 180 degree. So it is actually angle sum property of the triangle, and the another one is the exterior angle property, that it is saying that if a side of a triangle is produced, then the exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of the two opposite interior angles. So this we have to prove. Let us come on fastly see it also, so that we can cover all the things in one video only. So for the angle sum property, first of all, I'm just discussing with you all. So see, first of all, we'll take a triangle ABC, okay, triangle ABC, and then we'll do a construction over here. So construct a line. So I had written over here, draw a line LM passing to from point A such that LM parallel to BC. This line is going to be parallel to BC, okay. Now you can see over here, angle 4 is equals to angle 2 and angle 5 is equals to angle 3. Angle 4 is equals to angle 2, angle 5 is equals to angle 3. Alternate interior angles, okay. Now let us move on fastly. an angle sum property, sorry, not angle sum property, that too we have to prove now. So now we are using the straight angle property, 1 plus 4 plus 5, this is on a straight line, these all angles, so this sum equals to 180 degrees. So straight angle we had used it, and now we can replace angle 4 with angle 2 and angle 5 with angle 3. So angle 2 plus angle 1 plus angle 3 is equals to 180 degrees. Finally we had got our result, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus 3 angle 3 is equals to 180 degrees. Now let us move on to understand about the straight angle property. Let us take a triangle ABC again, ABC, and extend its one of its sides. Extended to D, and we had got an interior angle. Let us name this angle as angle 1. Okay, we had taken it. Now 2, 3, 4 are the interior angles. Let us start the proof. Angle 1 plus angle 4 is equals to 180 degree. Linear pair, we had taken it the first statement. Now angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equals to 180 degree. Angle sum property of the triangle. Right now we had used prove it. So see, now again we are using it to prove the another theorem. So from these two equations we can easily see that its RHS is equal, so LHS will also be equal. So angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to angle 2 plus 3 plus 4. So 4, 4 cancel out. So finally we will get angle 1 is equal to angle 2 plus 3. Angle 1 is the exterior angle and 2 and 3 are the opposite interior angles. So we had got our result. So we had proved the exterior angle property 2. I hope so that this thing, that the things must be clear to you people at last. This is the last property. So thank you everyone for being here and watching this video, and I hope so that the things must be clear to you people. So okay, that's it for today. We'll meet again in the next class. Thank you all of you.